everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be making a family home. I'm calling it the adorable blue family home. And this was supposed to be the base game starter home. So you're gonna see I don't want to say it's choppy, but it's a little bit, like, it changes through, like, the middle of the video, so you'll see that. But what happened was that I started building this house, and then I was, like, putting all the base game stuff down, and I had the mistake of putting the Parenthood kitchen stuff, you know, like, the counters and the refrigerator and, you know, stuff like that. And then I had to change it to base game, and I was like, no, it's so cute, I don't want it to be a base game build. So I just ended up changing it, and it's just a regular build. It's not that expensive. So it's like 109 simoleons. So, you know, if you get a sim and, you know, you marry another sim and, like, you move into the house, and then, you know, it'd be perfect. It's a perfect family home. It's a it's a 3-bedroom home, and then the garage was converted into a media room, or like a theater room. It has a little, like, wet bar in there, and then there's, like, a spare guest room at the top of the garage, once garage turned to entertainment room. So there's plenty of room for like a family. This is a perfect family home. And then I had the idea to make, like, I was gonna actually do the media room into the master bedroom, but by the time I thought about the idea, it was already too late. Like, I already finished the master bedroom. But however, you can definitely make the upstairs little guest room area into a bathroom, and then turn the garage / media room into the master bedroom. The only thing that's in there is the laundry, if you have the laundry stuff pack. But yeah, I know I've had some requests to make, like, base game stuff, and I really do, but I love using laundry. That's, like, the one thing, like, for if you're a builder and stuff like that, it's, like, the one thing to have that makes a house really realistic. Because, you know, before, I would make a room and it would just be, like, an empty room, and that'll be, like, the pretend laundry, but yeah, now I can actually have a laundry room. So, yeah. Anyway, this house has a really open, like, living room, kitchen area. So it's perfect for entertaining. It does have, like, a little bit of a backyard area. A deck area with barbecue. And in the backyard, it's just full of flowers. And I wanted to put more planters down, but I only put some in, like, specific area. If you have seasons, I put down Patchy, so he can help you with, you know, your flowering and stuff like that. But I wanted to make this, like, a plant, like a very, well, I don't even think I used the good soil one, but a very, like, plant friendly home. And then I did come up with the story for this one as well. So for this one, it's a same-sex couple, two guys, and they adopted two sons, and they're living here with, like, one boy who's, like, you know, into sports, into basketball, into baseball, into everything, you know, and then the other one who's kind of, like, okay, well, he's, like, in the closet, and for some reason, he's just afraid to, you know, be his true self, and he's always, like, in a, you know, he's scared, and, you know, he doesn't have to be, but he still is. So that's kind of, like, what I wanted to build the room as. I mean, there's not that many, like, dark things in The Sims, like, to make, I don't want to say emo room, but yeah, to make, like, an emo room. You know, in high school, we all had troubles. I know I did. You know, for a long time in high school, I did feel a little bit, you know, self-conscious about my weight and like how I look like. I had really, really, really bad acne, way worse than it is now. I still have some adult acne, but I don't care anymore. Like, I don't care what people think about me. I don't care about anything anymore. But back then, you know, in high school, you do care. So that's what this, you know, this teen is going through. He's going through a phase where, you know, I know my parents won't care. Like, I know my brother won't care, but I care, you know? So yeah. So this is the little family room with the little bookshelves here. And I do use a lot of Seasons, a lot of the Seasons stuff pack and Parenthood pack, I think. I think those are the things that I mix in with this build. I just feel like it was such a good combination with this house, you know? And then I did an accent wall on this wall and also in the master bedroom. Now, I have not tested to see if your Sim can sit at the dining table. It's a little bit tight, but I just didn't want to make it any more bigger. So I hope that they can sit there. If not, you can definitely expand it on the back a little bit more, you know, and just add a roofing. So yeah, so it'll be, it's a small kids bathroom. It should work though, I hope. Again, I did not test it. My computer's been acting slower than normal, so. And I love using that little tub from Parenthood Pack because I love the different colors that we can put in there. And I made it like a little green bathroom. And if you saw it in the kitchen, the countertops are blue and I left them blue and they're blue in the picture, but I actually changed them back to white because I like the blue and white balance. So when I do upload this to the gallery, it will be blue and white. So yeah, I changed the colors a little bit. And the bedrooms are a bit small, and your Sim should be able to get around in there, but they are a bit small. It's a bit on the small side. Like I said, it was going to be a base game build, and, you know, by the time I was finished with, like, the rooms and stuff, I just did not want to move it, because I loved the way the roofing looked, and I loved the way the house looked, so, yeah. This would be a perfect little family home. I did not put a doggy door or anything if you have pets, but you can definitely put that if you want. I don't think I put a dog food bowl in this build. And I'm just adding like a lot of detail to the room, like to the walls and stuff. And, you know, like I said, this kid, he likes sports. And sorry, that's my dog in the background barking. if you can hear that. He barks at the mailman or mail lady when they come drop off the mail. But yeah, so this will be the teen's room, and I really love that bedding. I don't know, I wish I had that bedding in real life, but yeah, this is a teen's room, and I do put a little bit of details here. Like I said, there's just not that much, you know. I wanted to make it like a little bit different, and I do put like posters and stuff, and I feel like this specific Sim will be like a poet, like a reader or writer or something, you know, loves to read, loves to write. So I put a lot of stuff there. And oh, I just remembered, I forgot to put the scouts thing, but you guys can definitely, if you guys get this, you can definitely add the scouts. And I also forgot to put the if you have Parenthood Pack, I forgot to put the oh my god, what is that called, the board where you set the curfew board. I forgot to put that in this build as well, but you can definitely add it on if you'd like, if you have the Parenthood Pack. You know, I'm so jealous of people who can like tell stories from The Sims. Like, I can do it, but I don't know, I haven't done it yet. I've said this a million times, so once I get a good computer, I'm definitely gonna start doing Let's Plays and stuff. Because I think it'll be super, super, super fun. So, yeah. So this is the master bedroom. So, I forgot to change the floors before I actually started. I actually did not notice until, like, later. I was like, oh, the floors are different. But, yeah. So, this is the master bedroom. Again, it's a bit small. Like I said, I was going to turn the meeting room into the master bedroom. And I completely forgot until after I finished decorating and I do the accent wall is black. I was gonna do the blue, but I saw this house, like this build on Instagram, and they did a black and white room, and I was like, oh my god, that's such a pretty room. I'm gonna do that one day. And so I did it with this one. The bedding, I did, you know, the bedding has a pop of color, and the side tables have a pop of color too. But yeah, I did like a black and white, semi black and white theme in this room. And I just wanted to add like little bits and bobs here. And the thing with like base game build is that I can't add the clutter items that I like unless I build a tiny home, like a smaller starter home. So I'm gonna try to do that. Right now I'm actually building another family home. It's a bigger house. But after that I will definitely try to do like a tiny base game home. Oh, sorry, I'm trying to scratch something. And so yeah, I have an idea of how the house will look like. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do next. And I really love this bathroom. Like I said, I wanted to do like kind of like a black and white bathroom theme. But yeah, I don't know, it's really pretty. I like it. And I couldn't find a space for the toilet, so I just put it there in the little corner there. I think we're gonna work on a media room soon, I hope. Oh, and if you have laundry days, the laundry day pack, I only put one laundry basket in this house, so you might want to add more laundry baskets because it gets annoying when they get too full. That's what I've noticed. And I just, you know, I just forgot. And then I do put like, you know, I put a little bit of a coffee maker in the kitchen. And then I put like, you know, that plant right there on the floor. It kind of, it's wheatgrass, so I put it like, you know, they make wheatgrass. So I probably should have put like the tea maker thing, so it looks like they juice wheatgrass. But yeah, so here it's blue, but like I said, in the pictures it'll be blue, the kitchen counters, not the counters, the thing on the, forgot what they're called, but yeah, they'll be white, so it'll be like a white and blue kitchen. And this is a little desk area for the kids or for the parents. I really love that computer from State of Living, so I always put that one in. And then here's where we make the media room / theater room. I did put a little game system for your Sims, and I used my favorite couch, of course, and I used it in blue. I wanted to have like a little bit of pop of color in this one, and I do make a little wet bar there. So, and I expanded the office a bit because it was a little bit cramped for me, and then there was like a little empty space behind the stairs, so I decided to put the laundry there. So yeah, and like I said, I should have put a radio in here so it can be like a little hangout place for the parents and stuff, because I put a little wet bar here. So yeah, I really like this house. Actually, I might use it for, you know, a family home. I like the story too that I've created. And then you'll see, I think you'll see the tiling here. Yeah, so I was gonna use this as a bathroom, and I was gonna use the downstairs as the master bedroom, but I just decided to use like a little loft guest space area. So if you have like another Sim, or like say the kids want to invite a friend over, they can have their own designated room. They don't have to sleep like on the couch or anything. So yeah, I wish I had sleeping bags in the Sims. That'd be cool for like sleeping, like slumber parties and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm just adding a little detail in the house, like little paintings. I really love that breakfast painting. That's like my favorite one. That one and the pancake one. I don't know why. So yeah, I'm building a little deck area in the back, and we will have a, what is that called? We'll have a barbecue area. That's what I'm thinking. Right here. So yeah, it's just a little one. There's a little seating in there, and a coffee table. But I wanted to make this the focus of like you know, how do I say this? not a planter's backyard, but a backyard where it's like very lush in flowers, very lush in vegetables, and you know, they want to grow their own food and they want to make it organic and they want to grow their own flowers. And I did put the little flower table in the back, so if you have seasons, again, your sim can definitely do a lot of planting here. There's plenty of room in this yard for your sim to just plant flowers anywhere they like. So yeah, that's what I did. And I used the romantic garden stuff for the rose bush, and I wanted to make like a rose designated bush area, which is right there next to the planters. So, and then I put patchy down. I just love patchy. I haven't used them, but I watched Pixelade and he was using patchy and he like almost burned down the house. That was kind of funny. But yeah, this house, this backyard, you can definitely add like a pool or the hot tub if you have the backyard stuff. I think it's the backyard stuff pack, I think, I'm not sure. But yeah, if you wanted to add like a hot tub back here, that's definitely a possibility. And then I just put those little I don't think they're fairy lights, but those little lights there. Finally, I was able to use them where it didn't look weird. so yeah, I was very happy about that. And like I said, it's not like a big back deck area, but it's a little bit like, I don't even know if your sim can get by there. Oh no, yeah, they can. There's plenty of room. But the focus was mainly on planting and flowers and, you know, that tree. But there's plenty of room for you to expand this house. There's plenty of room for you to expand the backyard if you want to make it, you know, the focus on growing flowers and growing plants for your sim. And yeah, I'm just adding like the little details here and there. I am gonna put a driveway at the front. I wish we had cars. I mean, not to drive, but just, you know, just to have. That'd be kind of cool. I know it's in The Sims 3, but it's not in The Sims 4, which is okay, because I feel like it'll be kind of glitchy if they did that. I'm just adding some little details in the front. And so if you want to download this house, it will be up on the gallery under Bubbly Simi. It will be named the Blue Adorable Blue Family Home. And then you can also look it up at hashtag Bubbly Simi. If you want to follow me on social media, it's Bubbly Simi for Twitter and Bubby Simi for Instagram. And if you like this video, go ahead and subscribe and hit the little bell. Go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up. And thank you all so much for watching, and have a lovely day.